quick update for September 30th, 2013. I'm Reginald, also known as Dimcat First. Another Italian prime minister dealing with a crisis. His government is in trouble. The economy is in a bad place. I mean, they're going to keep having some problems there because people aren't happy about the direction of which the country is going, and switching prime ministers obviously isn't really helping. Right here in the U.S., our jobless claims actually went down to a six-year low, which is pretty good. You know, actually went down to about 305,000 new people applying for unemployment benefits. Obviously, that's still a little elevated, but it's not as high as it used to be. What's happening? The unemployment rate here in America is dropping. There are some jobs, although they don't pay enough for you to actually survive off of. You know, some of these places want to give you like a six-hour shift, or they want to work you for 20, 25 hours a week, you know, paying you $8 an hour or something. I mean, go ahead. But hey, it did drop. There is some good news. The bottom line is there is no recovery, and this story right here pretty much says it all. Walmart, they're actually cutting orders on unsold merchandise. Now think about that. Walmart, the largest retailer in the country, largest brick-and-mortar retailer in the country, they're cutting back on merchandise orders because they can't sell enough product. Okay, these people rely on middle class, a lot of working class people to come in and buy their products. Okay, if the working class, a lot of lower middle class people can't really afford to buy their products and they're not really buying the stuff, what type of recovery are we really dealing with here? I mean, you look at the numbers right here. You know, it says that the chains are already bracing for a tough holiday season. You know, the projected sales are going to be 2.4% increase. That's their projected sales. It's going to be the smallest gain since 2009. We know what 2009 was like. This is according to Shopper Track. We'll see if that 2.9 really materializes. But yeah, you know, in the second quarter of this year, same store sales actually fell by 0.3%. U.S. retail orders are also dropping in other places. Nike, they're cutting back. A lot of apparel places are cutting back on their orders as well. But Japan's retail, actually, their sales went up by 1.1%. So a little good news for Japan. Germany's retail sales actually ended its two-month contraction because it's going down and down. It actually has a positive. And, back in July, they had a 0.2% contraction. Nothing great there, but they have some, just a modest growth of 0.3%, so a little growth there. The Greek retail is a nightmare. Failed 14%. Retail sales by volume dropped 14%. 14%. Holy crap, year on year. They're going through some trouble over there. I'll tell you that for sure. China, looks like their real estate maybe cooling off, to say the least. And here's a story that's really indicative. This lady called House Sister, okay, supposed to be this big real estate mogul or whatever. She's been accused of forging documents, purchasing documents, making illegal purchasing documents, fraud. Like, okay, if this lady's so well known and she's able to do this for a while and she finally got caught, what does it say about the rest of the market there? Okay, Chinese manufacturing growth is slower than expected, you know, or whatever. You can interpret that to whatever you want. The index was somewhere around, it rose to 50.2. Now, anything above 50 is a little growth. It went from 50.1 to 50.2. So it's right there on the edge. It's right there on the edge. Okay, banks. Okay, there's a lot of rumors about, you know, there's going to be a big event in October. You know, FEMA and Region 3, there's going to be some type of false flag attack. People are claiming nuclear this and that. I don't really go by rumors or anything. You guys can share your thoughts on all that stuff. But for me, I only focus on stuff that I can actually find real articles talking about it. Not just, you know, such and such, somebody posted something up on the internet based on a rumor or whatever. But anyway, banks plan a national cyber attack drill simulation designed to help test their defenses. It's going to be happening. It's going to be a two-day drill in October. Pretty interesting. You guys can check out that article. We'll see how that works out. China, they're so deep in Africa. Okay, they work in South Sudan. They're working with the mining sector. They have infrastructure deals, $1 and $2 billion road deals. Man, they're going to get that money. It is South Sudan. South Sudan is China. They're going to get that money. They have stuff going on in Kenya. They are going after it, okay? And they're not having to bomb people over it either. So, really interesting. Quick update there. So, guys, share your thoughts about if you think there's going to be a big event in October. And here's my question today. It has nothing to do with any of this. Have you ever been in a relationship with somebody and the in-laws or the would-be in-laws or family was so damn crazy it made you think twice about actually marrying that person or being with that person? I'm just going to leave a question out there for you guys. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.